Peace and blessings. Once again, it's your boy, Mr. Wildenfree. As you know, I've been away for far too long already. However, I am coming back with some genuine treats for you all. So hopefully, this is the video that answers a question you've had when it comes to working with Notion templates. Now, say you've downloaded one of my templates or any of the other templates provided by the Notion Creator Economy, and you notice that there's a brand new version of that template that has now rolled out that you want to take advantage of. This becomes critical when Notion starts to roll out newly released features, much like how database automations have just been announced. So what I'm going to show you today is how you can take your existing Notion systems and get the data from inside of those databases transferred into the brand new versions of those same databases. So let's go ahead and hop right into it. So we're talking about database upgrades and migrations. Let's consider two parallel systems built in Notion that serve the same purpose. We're going to use the Music OS as an example here. Say we have version 1 of this template system. So that's the Music OS 1.0. And then what we want to do is upgrade to the new Music OS Plus, which will be version 2.0. of that system. Now, what I have displayed here is the visual representation of these two systems in their entirety. And what I mean by that is when you look over to the left, you'll see a mermaid flowchart that represents the 5 databases that exist inside of the Music OS system. And to the right, we have a flowchart that represents the 8 databases that exist inside of the Music OS Plus system, AKA version 2.0. Another really important thing to recognize here is that all databases that exist in the old system also exist in the new version of that system. Now, this is for optimal data integrity. And what I mean by this is that all of the data in version 1 already has a predefined location to go in version 2. Now, this ensures that we are able to keep all existing data from those databases, but it also ensures that we have the opportunity to maintain the existing relationships that exist between each database in both of those systems. Cool. Now let's flow right along. Now, as I've mentioned, this is typical when you're working with template systems or upgradable versions. Using this table that's currently displayed, I'm giving an example based on templates that I have created to offer to the community. So you'll notice I have the Simple Music Dash, which provided downloaders of this template with the records database and the albums database alongside an actual page to operate out of. Right now, we're just focusing primarily on the databases themselves. From there, Music OS was an improvement on top of the Simple Music system by providing an additional 3 databases, which provided databases for the community to structure and organize their artists, a word bank, and even their audio plugins. From there, what's on the horizon will be the Music OS Plus system, which builds on top of that to provide yet another 3 databases. So including the artists, word bank, and audio plugins databases, Music OS Plus will go beyond that to provide you with the Music Tags database, the Music Gear database, and the Tech Stack database. Now, using that as an example, say there is a community member who is using the current Simple Music Dash system. They want to be able to take their data from the records database and their albums database and transfer that over into the Music OS system, keeping the data integrity intact, making sure that all of their records and all of their albums and the corresponding relationships between them are maintained when they transfer over to that new Music OS system. Now, let's say that there is a community member who is currently using the Music OS system. They will also want to transfer over their data from their artist, word bank, and audio plugins databases into that new Music OS Plus system that will have those additional benefits. So that is effectively our goal with today's lesson, is to provide a means for you all to transfer your data from one previous version of a system into a new and improved system. And this goes for anybody's template structures. It's not just with templates that I provide to the community, but also any other Notion creator out there who is providing you all with templates. Hopefully they have structured their templates in such a way that it makes it easy for you to migrate your data from your existing version into a newer, improved version of that template or system. Now, I want to highlight some goals for a data migration. We want to make sure that the existing data gets mapped to the appropriate property columns in the new system. We want the relation properties to keep their relevant connections. We also want important changes from our first system to not be lost once we transfer that data over to the new system. Now, an example might be new template pages that you've added to this particular database or system, additional views or linked views of said databases, and new property columns. So these are the things that we're going to discuss here in a moment. And while we may not be able to automate all of those, I will break down for you what will work when it comes to transferring data and getting that data merged successfully into that new system, and what you might need to have a bit more of a manual interaction. So let's keep moving on. Now, this is the most important thing. In order for this to work, the entire system must have been duplicated altogether in its entirety. Once the system has been created, every database that is related to one another should exist inside of the same parent page. And that parent page is what should get duplicated. And ideally, both the original system and the new system have been duplicated in this way, but that's ideal. I'm not sure if that's required. If you are using a system that you've derived from a template, then this is likely to be the case already. Now, duplicating or creating one database at a time and then remapping the relations based on the system's relational database settings will not work. So what I mean by that is, say for instance, you have your existing Music OS setup. What you won't want to do is gain access to that template page and then try to copy and paste or duplicate individual databases to then try to migrate to your own system. You'll want to have that entire system duplicated and transferred over into your workspace. That will ensure the highest chance of data integrity when it comes to migrating your data to that new system. And below, I just have a call out that represents that entire system existing inside of a parent page that you will then duplicate into your own workspace. Now, moving right along, what we have here are migration behaviors. What I'm representing here with this table is how changes you might have made in the original version of that template or system will impact the migration behaviors when you transfer that data from one version to the next. So first off, we'll address any changes that still allow for the data to map appropriately into that new version. So say for instance, you have changed the order of the properties, or you have renamed certain properties, or you have changed the property type to a compatible format. And what I mean by that is like changing a text property to a select property, or a select property to a text property, or a select property to a multi-select property. If you change it to a compatible property type, all of that data will migrate successfully without any issues, and you'll see it represented once you transfer that data over. Likewise, with my testing, when you rename a property type, so long as the data within remains the same, the property types remain the same, and the context or the relevance of that title remains the same, the data should transfer over without creating a new property field, but merging that data and representing it appropriately. Now, when you create a brand new property in your original database, that is one of those actions or change behaviors that upon migration will result in a new property being created. Now, keep in mind, this property will likely be hidden by default. So when you do this, make sure you check your hidden properties. Another thing to note here is that typically you'll have to have some value represented in that property field in order for that data to get transferred over to that new version. Now let's talk about unique behaviors. Let's say that you've changed one of those original property types into an incompatible property type. The unique behavior that will happen here is that when you migrate that data into that new version of the system, it's gonna look like that data has disappeared altogether, like it did not transfer. However, if you take that new version of the template and you go to that specific property column, and you convert it back into a property column that is compatible with the original version of that system, then you will see that the data is maintained. So that's incompatible property type changes. Next, status property columns. If you have a status property column on both versions of a template, but the new version of the template doesn't have all of the options from the previous version, say you've added some additional options, those new options won't immediately get transferred over to that new version. So you will have to recreate those status options before you do the transfer to make sure that they get paired when you merge the data. Lastly, we'll go over changes that do not occur upon transfer. And what that would be, like I mentioned before, is your new template pages. If you have brand new template pages that you've added to the original version that are unique to your setup, those won't be represented on the new versions of that template. And just transferring your data won't automatically merge that template to the new system. Any automations from one database to another, the upgraded version of that, won't transfer. Database views, unique database views that you've configured, will not transfer to that new version of the database. Linked views of database, unfortunately, will not transfer. You have to recreate new linked views wherever you have instances of that database represented. Lastly, buttons referencing relational databases. Say, for instance, you have buttons inside of database pages that when you click on it, automatically generate a relation property to one of the existing databases in that system. When you transfer that data over into that new version, you'll have to upgrade those buttons to correspond with the new relations in that new system. Cool. So hopefully this was helpful to you all, just to kind of talk through it, to visually see the things that we need to keep in mind while we're doing this data transfer. And so now I finally get to show you all exactly how this works. So what I'm going to do is take the data from version one and I'm going to transfer it over into version two. This is how you can do it within your own system, okay? Now, when you are working with your existing data, say that this records 1.0 had 300 different unique pages in it. What you will want to do is load all of the pages so that you can select them all at once. When you hover over the property header, if you go all the way over to the left-hand side, you'll notice a little white square that appears. Click on that white square and you will select everything inside of that database that has been loaded. So once you've done that, you're gonna click on these three dots in the dynamic menu that appears, and then you're gonna click on move to. Once you do that, you're going to identify that new database that corresponds with the database you're currently working with. So as an example, going from records 1.0 to records 2.0. And if they're not named that blatantly, just take a look at the actual breadcrumbs underneath the title to help you navigate where you need to go with this new system. So I'm taking the proper steps to select everything in records 1.0, and I'm now moving them all to records 2.0. What I want you all to pay attention to is notice how the artist property is a relation property. And I have artists selected in these fields. So when I go ahead and I click move to and I transfer that data over to this new database, notice the artists are now gone. I don't want you to panic, okay? What I'm going to do now is go over to the artists database and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to transfer the data from the artist 1.0 database into the artists 2.0 database. So that's what we have represented down here. I'll go ahead and give this some more space. And now we have artist 1.0 and artist 2.0. I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm going to select all of the database pages that exist within that database. I'm going to click on the three dots in the dynamic menu that appears. I'm going to click on move to, and now I'm going to transition those items to the artist 2.0. And now watch, once I do that, when I scroll back up, you will see that the artists and the relations between that data were maintained. So I was actually able to keep the relationship between two different databases in a previous system and migrate them over to a brand new system and keep those values the same. So that's how we want to do our data transfers for optimal data integrity. Now, I'm going to undo that because I want to show you something really quickly. The reason why this Records 2.5 database exists is because I wanted to show you all, I duplicated this records database independently of the entire system. And then I went back in and I mapped it to the corresponding databases, right? So the artist database, the albums database, you know, et cetera, et cetera. Now I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna take these records from 1.0 and I'm gonna move them to records 2.5. Now notice, one, the data got transferred, but the status properties didn't remain the same because those new status properties did not exist in this new version. Second, the artist property is currently empty, but let's see what happens when I migrate from artist 1.0 to artist 2.0. I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm going to select all of the artists. I'm going to migrate them and move to artists 2.0. Now, the artists now exist in artist 2.0. The artist property column here, that's artist 2.0, but notice those values were not transferred over when I made that migration. I'll scroll back up here to show you. That's why it's important for the entire system to be duplicated together at once. Because if you try to do this in parts, even if you map each relationship back exactly the way that it was, the integrity of the connection between those relationships will not remain intact, okay? So you want to make sure that the entire system is duplicated all at once when you're doing these kinds of data transfers. Awesome. So I just went ahead and I undid that move, and I'm just gonna reset it back to having all of the data back into version 2.0. So moving everything back from 1.0 to 2.0, just to show you that it's flexible and dynamic and I can do that. And I'll move the data from the artist database into artist 2.0. So now you'll see the relationships remain intact. The relationships remain intact. And the same applies for any other database configuration. Here I have version 1.0 and I'll transfer that data over to albums 2.0. And you'll see here the records, the ones that were related, maintained that integrity, okay? Maintained the integrity. So that is getting your data transferred from one version of a system into that new version of a system. Lastly, what I will say in regards to templates, if you have brand new templates that you've configured that you want transferred into that new database, what you'll have to do, unfortunately, is go into that database, copy all of the elements inside of it. I highlighted them all by hitting Command A and then Command C to copy. Go over to that brand new database, add in that new template, and then drop in those elements by hitting Command B to paste, okay? Now, for the property configurations of that template, you will have to go back in and reset those as well, okay? So that's just par for course. But once you have this template set up, you're all good to go to start using it for your newer project. And with that, I hope I provided you all with a ton of value here in this video. Today, we discussed database upgrades and migrations. So moving from existing template systems and migrating that data over into new versions of those templates and systems. I hope this allows you all to take advantage of some of these newer features that are rolling out for Notion, and all of the incredible templates that will have a lot of these new features implemented. All right, so that's all for now. Till next time, peace and blessings. Peace and blessings.